Hello everyone, this is Raghavendra Patil GE, Assistant Professor, CS&D Department, SDMIT, Ujre. Now I will discuss dual simplex method in operation research. These are the textbooks I have referred: Operation Research by D.S. Hira and P.K. Gupta, Operation Research by S.D. Sharma, and Operation Research by Srinivas Reddy M. Now, let us discuss about dual simplex method. In simplex method, if one or more solution values, that is XB value, are negative and optimality condition is satisfied, then the solution may be optimum but not feasible. In such cases, a variant of simplex method called dual simplex method would be used. In the dual simplex method, we always attempt to retain optimality while bringing the primal back to feasibility, that is XBI greater than or equal to 0 for all I. Now, algorithm of dual simplex method or procedure of dual simplex method. So here we have 8 steps are there. So now let's discuss about 8 steps one by one. In step 1, convert the problem into maximization problem if it is initially in minimization form. Step 2, convert greater than or equal type constraints, if any, into less than or equal type by multiplying minus 1 on both sides of the constraint. In step 3, convert the inequality constraints into equalities by addition of slack variables. In step 4, express the above information in the form of table known as the dual simplex table. And if the optimality condition is satisfied and one or more basic variable have negative value, then the dual simplex method is applied. In step 5, the basic variable with most negative value becomes living variable and call the respective row as pivot row. If more than one element for living variable exist, choose any one. In step 6, obtain the ratio by dividing all Zj minus Cj values by the corresponding pivot row, then the entering variable EV is the one which is the least negative value in the ratio. In step 7, compute the new values for new iterations. In step 8, repeat step 5 to step 7 until there are no negative values in the basic variable column. So these are the 8 steps are involved in the procedure of dual simplex method. Now let's solve the one problem. Use your dual simplex method to solve the following problem. Here they were given objective function and 3 constraints. Objective function is maximized at -2x1, -3x2. Subjected to constraint x1 plus x2 greater than or equal to 0. And second constraint 2x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 0. And third constraint x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 0. And non-negative variable x1 comma x2 greater than or equal to 0. So solution for this, the given problem, the objective function is already in maximization type, hence it is in standard form. And in the given constraint, out of 3 constraint, first constraint is having greater than or equal inequality, so it should be converted to less than or equal. That is, first constraint is x1 plus x2 greater than or equal to 2 is there. It should be converted to -x1, -x2, less than or equal to -1. So that is multiplying minus on both sides. Now, the constraint should be converted as equation. So by adding what slack variable? So 3 constraints are converted as equation. So that is first constraint -x1, -x2, plus s1 equal to -2. Next, second constraint 2x1 plus x2 plus s2 equals to 10. Then third constraint x1 plus x2 plus s3 equals to 8. So the constraint should be converted as equation by adding the slack variable. Then next non-negative variable x1 comma x2, s1 comma s2 comma s3 greater than or equal to 0. Then our objective function will becomes, that is the modified objective function. So maximize z is equal to -2x1, -3x2, plus 0s1, plus 0s2, plus 0s3. So by using these information by using the information from constraint and objective function. So we should construct the, we have to construct the simplex table. So it contains, see here in the first iteration, so we're having a basic variable in the first column, basic variable s1, s2, s3, and coefficient of that basic variable, all values are zero, and xb values, that is a constraint right hand side value, x1 value, x2 value, s1 value, s2 value, and s3 value. And cj value is the coefficient of decision variable. So these values should be what placed in the simplex table. So after that, we need to check the optimality check, optimality condition. So here optimality condition is checked by using the expression zj minus cj. That is, we need to compute zj minus cj. So before computing zj minus cj, we need to compute the zj value. So that is the summation of cb into xb and cb into x1, similarly cb into x2, so on up to cb into s3 we need to compute. And after that, we need to take the difference between summation, we need to take the difference between zj minus cj. So this is the value, zj value, summation of cb into xb 0, and so on up to summation of cb into s3. So all the values, all the zj values are 0. Then we need to compute the zj minus cj, take the difference between zj and cj. So we'll get 2, 3, 0, 0, 0. So here all the zj values are, all the zj values are greater than or equal to 0. So this means our solution zj equal to 0 is the optimal solution. So what we got, the solution is optimal. But here in the xb column, we are having negative value is there. So that's why what we got, the solution is optimal, but it is not feasible. So further, we can improve our solution. This zj value can be improved. So in the next iteration. So for that, we need to compute, we need to know the living variable and we need to know the entering variable. So here, living variable will becomes the most negative value in the basic variable column. The most negative value in the basic variable column will be the minus 2, and its corresponding variable s1 is the living variable. See here in the next step, see here in the basic variable column, minus 2 is there, its corresponding variable will be s1. So s1 will becomes the living variable, the most negative value in the basic variable. And we need to find the entering variable. Entering variable is obtained by taking the ratio, that is by dividing all the values by the all, by dividing all the zj minus cj value by the corresponding pivot row. So this zj minus cj values are divided by this pivot row. See, in the next step, the ratio will be computed. Zj, by dividing all the zj minus cj values with the pivot row. So 2 divided by minus 1, 3 divided by minus 1, 0 by 1, 0 by 0, 0 by 0. So the ratio will be minus 2, minus 3, 0, 0, 0. So here entering variable will be chosen with the most least negative value in the ratio. So 2, that is x1 variable will be the entering variable. X1 variable will be the entering variable, which is least negative value in the ratio. Okay, next, after identifying the living variable and entering variable, so here s1 is replaced by x1 in the second iteration. Okay, see, so now we'll proceed to second iteration. Here also we're having a basic variable cb in the simplex table, basic variable cb, xb, x1, x2, s1, s2, s3, and cj value. So basic variable are now x1, s2, and s3, because s1 is replaced by x1. Okay, now, so this x1 row values, new values are computed by using what? The x1 row is obtained by dividing the entire pivot row by using key element. So the by using previous row, that is pivot row, that entire row is divided by using key element. Key element is minus 1, this one. So by dividing that entire row by minus 1, we will get the new values for x1 row. Similarly, for s2 and s3, we need to compute the new values. So that is computed by using the formula, that is new element is equal to old element minus entering column coefficient into corresponding pivot element. Old element minus entering column coefficient into corresponding pivot element. By using this formula, we will compute the S2 and S3 row values. After computing S2 and S3 row values, we need to perform optimality check. We need to check the optimality condition. That is what we will get the solution. So whether it is optimal or not. So here we will compute the ZJ value. So for new second iteration ZJ value. So the ZJ values are -4. So similarly, it is the summation of CB into XP. So on up to summation of CB into S3 we need to perform. So ZJ values -4, -2, -2, 2, 0, 0 we will get. After that, we need to perform ZJ minus CJ, taking the difference between ZJ minus CJ. Okay. So all the ZJ minus CJ values are greater than or equal to 0. Okay. And in the basic variable column, there is no negative value will be present. So what we got the solution, ZJ value -4 is the optimal solution and then the feasible solution. See, all ZJ values are positive and no negative value in the basic variable column. Hence, the above solution is optimal and feasible. See here, all ZJ minus CJ values are positive and no negative value in the XB variable column. Not this ZJ value, only for variable. We need to see only for variable. No negative value in the basic variable column. And all ZJ minus CJ values are positive. So we reached optimality condition. We reached optimal condition. So what we got the solution, maximize Z equals to -4 is the optimal solution and feasible solution. So when X1 equals to 0, 2 and X2 equals to 0. So this is the solution for the given problem. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.